everybody, how's it? Aloha, this is Jeebs here. This is day four of Stoner Rock Week and all the subgenres of stoner rock, stoner metal. I'm beginning to learn a little bit more about that genre. I was cleared up, as to have said, when I asked for help, because you guys know I'm diving through this and I don't know, so you guys help me out with this, that apparently stoner rock was before the new metal. I thought for some reason it was a little after, but hey, this is the great thing about this channel, is that I get to do what I do and you kind of like hanging out, hey, wow, you know, skumbarish, yeah. And then, best for me is I get to learn from you guys, because, I mean, I might as well be 14 years old going through this journey, because I'm just getting fully blown away with almost 10 months of doing this channel and having such a blast. The Sword, Cloak of Feathers, right now. All right, guys, you know the jig. Want to buy me a cup of coffee, because you know these videos don't monetize the channel. Link will be down below. Link down below for the headsets, AKG240s. You want to just check them out? The link also for The Sword Spotify. And finally, the link for my Patreon. If you don't want to buy me a cup of coffee, you want a little something for your money, check out my Patreon. If you decide to hang out for a month, that's perfect. Bunch of stuff that you can get there as well, because what I do on Patreon stays on Patreon. So let's do this. The Sword, Cloak of Feathers. All right. Okay, without a doubt, the more I'm going through this is my fourth song as I'm diving into stoner rock, and without a doubt, what really pulls at me, especially for my age and being around, you know, in the late 60s, all through the 70s, is this kind of raw, powerful metal, and that's what this all seems to be to me has been, is so far only four songs into God knows how many great bands there are in this genre. Just the raw power of everything and the human element and the performance and what's going on here. So you have that great riff that's going on. Very black, deep purplish, you know, especially where there's a lot of the stop while the vocals, the melody goes through and then they pick up back on the riff. You know, and also the tone of the voice as well, the performance on this. But the bottom end and the whole bottom end of the mix and everything is so fat and it's so rich and it's it definitely is takes a little bit more precedence in the mix, too early in the morning, mix, you know, how it punches through. So, and then of course you saw me smile because of what? I need more cowbell, you know. It's, you know, when I hear cowbell, automatically I'm going back into the 70s and everything. All right, let's continue on. We'll be right back. I'm sorry. I will go back. We'll get into the solo. I know that sounded like it's probably the worst place for me to stop, but I just got to glam for 5 seconds. The bass. I love it when the bass takes their routes and their passages. So in other words, they're following in unison, but when it comes to wrapping around, much like tom-toms on the fill of a drum and stuff, they have a little more liberty and they can skate around a little more, and I'm loving that. So I'll go back a little bit now so we can kind of get ourselves juiced up for the solo. Apparently it seems like a solo's coming. Just reflect on the drum engineering on this. I want you to listen to the tom-toms and how they seem a little disconnected from the kit, in the sense that it's got a nice big fat snare. The kick is nice and just kind of it's got a life of its own because of the compression, kind of gives it this kind of swelling kind of punch to it. But I want you to listen to how the tom-toms seem to have kind of a delayed reflection on it, and it sounds like to me like they probably relied a little bit more on the room sound from the overheads over the drums and really blended that to be perhaps a little hotter in the mix than mics on the toms. It's hard for me to kind of place, you know, I'm just trying to go on my own short experience of engineering in the 80s and stuff, and you know, trying to listen to it. But to listen to that, it sounds disconnected, but it sounds really super cool because the toms have this nice reflection on there. So let me go back a little bit and we'll continue up. Okay, I'm hearing birds, unless it's a bad flashback from one of my tie stick days. Remember, I made that joke in the Monday video. You know what I loved about this, and this is what I'm learning about the genre, is that they really stick to the super raw tactics of recording the tracks. To me, it feels like, for instance, instead of doing a lot of post work on it, which is to add this, you know, reflections and reverbs and compressions and super compressed sounds and making them tight and shiny and kind of crispy and stuff, that they're just relying on the instruments, the cabinets, whether, you know, sometimes the bass might be a direct line and also cabinet, mic'd, et cetera, et cetera. That it just reminds me of the days of when I, you know, back in the analog recording days when bands would come through, if they were doing demos in the studio I was working in especially, it was just about getting them set up, getting them into the right mics, obviously, and it's all based on their performance. And to me, when I was listening a little more to the drums after I made my statement and stuff, and it sounds like it's just the raw room sound of wherever it is that they were recording. And they just maybe, I don't know, there's times where you can put double overheads over the kits like this, and then another pair of overheads way deep in the room, just so you could pick up that reflection and room reverb and actually, you know, work with that in the mix and stuff. But I also, you know, one of the great things about this, obviously you saw me just freaking about the bass. The bass sound on this was so fat and so rich, but nice and punchy. It had a nice little mid bite to it. What I like about it is the human aspect of performing this song. You know, there is bliss in imperfections. By no stretch of the imagination was I saying anything about this was imperfect. But when you get used to listening to the kind of music that's been tracked in the last 20 years, I've mentioned this before, it's not necessarily a bad thing. Sometimes it goes with the genres of extreme prog or something like that. You have the abilities to nudge things in your session. You know, make everything really nice and tight so everything is absolutely perfect. You know, the stop starts and, of let's just say chugging and all kinds of stuff. In this case, you can hear string buzzing noises and stuff like that. There were a couple times on the left side where the guitar actually, in between the turnarounds, kind of threw in a little bit of a riff that wasn't doubled on the right side. So that makes it feel more raw, more in your face, in kind of a metal intimate kind of way, if that's such a way to put it. But literally, it's right here in front of you, and it feels one take. It feels like the performance is just, let's do this, guys. Okay, we're gonna track 15 songs in 5 days. Let's get it all right. Anyhow, I wanna thank you very much. This was The Sword, Cloak of Feathers. Tomorrow, I'm vacillating between two bands right now. I'm thinking, I don't know, Stone Jesus, or gosh, I don't know. There's so many. I might have to extend this next week. What do you think? Maybe extend one more week of this, or get back into some more of the heavier stuff. I don't know. We'll see how I roll. I've been in a really super good mood. I've been having a great time with people leaving really cool comments, and Patreon is going off, and I'm just in a good space. So, you know, I'm not chasing subs. I'm not chasing, acts. I think the reason why I brought that up is somebody left a comment that I caught about 5 months ago when there was this big drop in my subs and stuff, and I said, what the hell just happened? And then, you know, there are some of the ones that are a little more of the purists and stuff, and as soon as I started drifting, it got a little and now I'm at a really good place, and you guys who've been here and still continue to come, you know, so I'm just having a great time with this, and I really appreciate you guys hanging out and all that sort of fun stuff. Anyhow, want to buy me a cup of coffee? Link is down below. Link is down below for everything I mentioned, the Sword, Spotify, the headsets, and please check out the Patreon and see if there's something there that you dig. And, you know, like I said, just hang out for a month if you don't want to do the whole show, or a cup of coffee, or just hang in there and just enjoy the music. I don't know. I'm just having a killer time doing this. You guys take care. Aloha.
All right.